Thank you. join in the opening sentences. The people who walked in darkness. For to us a child is born. His name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God. Glory to God in the highest.
And peace to God's people on earth.
Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the people.
to be praised. He is more to be feared than all gods.
As for all the gods of the nations, they are but idols, but it is the Lord who made the heavens.
Lord, I ask thee in thy presence, our prayers. Lord, I ask thee in thy presence, our prayers.
Ascribe to the Lord, you families of peoples. Ascribe to the Lord honor and power.
Ascribe to the Lord honor to his name. Bring offerings and honor to his courts.
Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth tremble before him.
Let the nations, the Lord is king. He has made the world so firm and cannot be moved. He will judge the peoples in equity.
Let the heavens rejoice and let the earth be glad. Let the sea thunder and all that is in it. Let the field be joyful and all that is herein.
And shall all the trees of the world shall have joy, before the Lord when he comes to judge the earth.
He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with his truth.
This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was the governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver the child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them at the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Amen.
Wednesday afternoon, my husband Bill and I hauled a bunch of furniture around. We carried the futon outside around the back of the house and into the basement. We disassembled the bed in the basement, brought it upstairs. We carried the bed frames and mattresses and box springs for the two beds to the new guest room. After a lot of huffing and puffing, we finally started to tackle particle board trundle bed. But as you might guess, being particle board, it weighed more than my car. I lifted it about 2 inches off the ground, placed it down, and then called my nephew. Hello, Adrian? Can you come help your uncle? I was done. But you see, we were preparing a room in our home for two Afghan refugees. We had already prepared our TV room months ago. But we had it stuck in our mind that it would be an older couple like us. We had prepared by having background checks for our whole family. We acquired new towels and bedding. Our home was inspected. We set aside space in the pantry, the fridge for the guests, and much more. And then we waited. For 2 months, we waited. But the refugee system was overwhelmed. So the sending out of refugees from the military camps was slow. Finally, 2 days ago, we got the call. We were asked to take in not an older couple, but two younger brothers, ages 15 and 24, from Kabul. They would arrive the next day, yesterday, the day before Christmas Eve. In other words, we were given 24 hours notice to get ready at the busiest time of year. And they weren't the refugees we had planned for. And the timing was the worst. Suddenly, I had to plan for extra food for our holiday meals and gifts under the tree, in addition to all the usual needs of refugees. And as described, we had to rearrange the room and switch beanbag for two twins. This is not what we expected, and the timing is not ideal. Can we do this? On this holy night, as we celebrate our Savior's birth, we remember the line in the Gospel of Luke which reads, "And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn." No place for them in the inn. What would it be like to arrive at a foreign town or country with no place to stay? Joseph and Mary were required to leave their home because of the census commanded by the emperor, traveled all the way to Bethlehem, which is crowded because many others are doing exactly the same thing. They don't have Expedia to reserve a room ahead of time. Mary is pregnant. This is not what they expected, and the timing is not good. Can they do this? Fortunately, for Bill and me, and Mary and Joseph, for these young Afghans, and for all the rest of us, God is in charge. God is a master at handling the poor timing of the unexpected. For Jesus, God provided a manger, swaddling clothes, loving parents, and a baby safely born. For us and the young Afghan men who arrived yesterday evening, God provided a translator, an orientation committee, someone to prepare a welcome meal, someone to buy Christmas presents, and people to take them out clothing shopping today. God bless them. All I had to do was provide a bed and a roof, and the good people of our team did the rest. They are God at work. Because that is one of the primary ways in which God cares for us, in the words and actions of those around us. And it works the other way as well. We ourselves are the hands and feet of God in the world. uses each of us to ensure that we and others get what we need, regardless of expectation or timing. What we get may or may not be what we want or expect, but what we need. And God makes sure it works out. For Mary and Joseph, it may have only been a manger and not be hoped for in. For us, it may be two young men 2 days before Christmas rather than the expected elderly couple in the middle of October. But in both cases, God gives us what we need. Most importantly, God gives us Jesus. You see, love and care for others can be expressed through saying loving things to them, verbalizing love, but it also is shown through physical actions. For instance, Bill shows his love for me when he cleans and vacuums my car. I show my love for my kids when I hug them goodnight. My kids show their love for their friends when they buy them a favorite game on their birthday. Our refugee team shows their love for our Afghan guests by providing them with their needs as they transition to life in the U.S. We all physically express love in our physically corporeal selves, not just verbally. So too, God realizes that just loving us from on high or through other people doesn't always get across what she wants us to know. So God also entered into the physical world, into the incarnate, into the material world, to physically love us. God incarnate as Jesus so we could tangibly see and touch and know God's love. In this way, through Jesus, God could heal, teach, walk along, and experience the same suffering and joys that we do. And in the end, Jesus could transcend and transform that suffering. The best leaders don't stand above their people, telling them what to do. Best leaders walk alongside their people, guiding them forward so the people trust and know that we're all in this together. Out of love, God came down to join us in the physical world and walk alongside us. Jesus wasn't what the world expected. This helpless, inconsequential baby in a rural backwater of the empire. The timing also didn't seem great. Why didn't the Messiah come sooner? But God is in charge and gives us not what we expect, but what we need. Our refugees are safe and starting a new life. Bill and I got our house prepared and are learning new things. Jesus was born safely, and his mission is changing the world. To stand if you are able and join us in saying the affirmation of faith in your bulletin. Let us declare our faith in God. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith, who fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, strengthens us with the power of the mind. We believe in God, the Father.
Son, and Holy Spirit.
The congregation may kneel.
Prayers of the people. Please let us pray to the Lord. Almighty God, in this holy night, your Son, our Savior, was born in the new flesh. Renew your church as the body of Christ. Holy God, in this holy night, there was no room for your Son in the end. Protect with your love those who have no home and all who live in poverty. Holy God, in this holy night, Mary, in the pain of labor, brought your Son to birth. Hold in your hand all who are in pain or distress, especially those on our parish prayer list. Holy God, in this holy night, your Christ came as a light shining in the darkness. Bring comfort to all who suffer in the sadness of our world. Holy God, in this holy night, the angels sang, peace to God's people on earth. Strengthen those who work for peace and justice in all the world. Holy God, in this holy night, shepherds in the field heard good tidings of joy. Give us grace to preach the gospel of Christ's redemption. Holy God, in this holy night, strangers from the Holy Family and saw the baby lying in the manger. Bless our homes and all whom we love, especially those for whom we give thanks, with our altar poinsettias. Holy God, in this holy night, heaven has come down to earth, and earth is raised to heaven. Hold in your hand all those who have passed through death and the hope of your coming kingdom, especially those listed in our poinsettial memorials. Holy God, in this holy night, Christians the world over celebrate Christ's birth. Open our hearts that he is born in us today. Holy God, gracious God, in this holy night, angels and shepherds worshiped at the manger throne. Receive the worship we offer in fellowship with Mary, Joseph, and the saints through him, who is your word made flesh, our Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The peace of Christ be always with you. Please greet each other with a sign of peace. God's peace. Please have a seat. Again, it's lovely seeing all of you here. And last year at this time, we were outdoors, so this is an improvement, even if the windows are open. Think about that. So just a few brief announcements. Services tomorrow, we have one Christmas Day service at 9 a.m. On the next day, Sunday, we will not have 8 and 10. We again will have just one service at 9 a.m. And it will be Christmas lessons and carols on Sunday. So if you were able to make those services, you'd love to see. If you'd like to make a donation to the church, we have an offering plate in the back of the church. You can leave something there, donation on your way out. You can also give online 24/7. Hits you in the middle of the night. Gosh, I'd like to donate to Emmanuel. You can get on our website. You're so lucky. You're in luck. Get on the website, and there's a way to do it there. Final note, in a few minutes, we will be celebrating Holy Communion. I'd like you to know that all are welcome to receive if you feel so moved to receive communion, regardless of your background. If you would prefer, if you'd like to come up and receive blessing. For you to do that, just come forward, cross your arms over your chest, and I'll give you a blessing. Walk in love as Christ loved us, gave himself for us an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
strangers, showed mercy to sinners, and taught us to follow him in love without fear. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, of all the things that are yours, we offer you these, which are yours especially. We offer them gladly, as he told us to remember his death and resurrection, his birth in Bethlehem and rest in the manger, his welcome to shepherds and strangers, as we praise and bless you. We praise you,
we bless you,
we give thanks to you,
and we pray to you, Lord our God.
Now pour out your spirit on this bread and wine to make them the body and blood of Christ for your awakening people. Come among us and abide with us, that we may be the body of Christ for the world we love. Shine upon us tonight as you shone upon the faithful Mary, as you shine upon your people in the darkest times and places, that lit by your love may heal and bear good tidings in your name. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, "Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." Thank you.
Thank you. Oh,